The validity of fine art departments has often been in question with their high cost and small financial return. Over the last few years, with the dire economic situation of the country, many departments were threatened with closure. One such department, suffering the uncertainty of this difficult period, decided to arm itself and combat the whole of economy's bureaucratic force. Typography, sculpture, and painting banded together to form a strong united front against economy. They are here shown weapon drill and instruction. The field easel, the 1.5 millimeter, is an important part of our boys' armory. Major Harvey, bristling with knowledge in the use of these weapons, is eager to answer any questions that these young recruits might have. Few, if any, of these boys fired a rifle in their lives before the intensive training scheme began. What is more, they are getting little opportunity to do so, as all the standard weapons are smoothbore, deadly to the range of the length of a large painting. Steely and virile, the strength of General Lane's troops lies with their unity and single aim to save the art department from economic extinction. The Minister of Money and his evil helper, Secretary Boris Bank, were underestimating the strength of their new foe. Threatened with grant cuts and paint restrictions, these artist boys will fight to their last cheese roll. Private Wilson, Town Library Brigade. Gunner Lord, Sculptural Artillery Company. Regan, Private, Art Historical Percussion Band. Longston, Constructivist Rocket Corps. They're off to the stirring sound of the Art Historical Percussion Band. Nothing will stop the FADM in their objective. The minister, Sir Monty Money, had better loosen his wallet before these boys do it for him. And you'll get the nice girl
too. Betty, is that Jimmy's ring you're wearing?
He said, Johnny Brown, say goodbye to life in town. Get up, boy, at 5 in the morning with the rising sun. All the little girls you know will follow you everywhere when once they see you, boy. Shouldering up your guns will be such fun.
Mm-hmm.
To use a gun. And your mother will be ever so proud of her great big son.
By the way, where'd you meet him?
Yes, we see.
That's when I fell for the leader of the pack. My folks were always putting him down.
Down, down.
They said he came from the wrong side of town.
What do you mean when you say that he came from the wrong side of town?
They told me he was bad.
Thank you.
first objective is the crossing of White Knight's Drift, a dangerous task due to the location of Economy's deadly halfpenny canister howitzers on the heights above the drift. The engineers did some of the most gallant deeds in assembling pontoons under the very nose of Economy's half-crown bombardment. It was probably the half-penny canister and the 4-inch half-crown shells that inflicted more damage on the artists than any other weapon possessed by Economy. Obsolete coins were used by Economy in order that no cashing in of shrapnel after the bombardment could take place. Receiving the first heavy half-crowns at White Knight under dastardly conditions resulted in 2 wounded, and in an army of 25, this could have had serious consequences. Mentioned in dispatches from this action were Heth Thomas from the Welsh contingent, who while eating a tomato, received a half-crown and old penny shrapnel in the head. Believed to be mutilated beyond all help, it was realized that the majority of the gore was from the coloration of the tomato, and for being funny, he was awarded with an outdoor watercolor set. Private Bryden of the Typography Infantry suffered an ear wound after connecting with a piece of cannon barrel when the artillery received a direct hit. He fought on till dusk and the bars opened. For this action, he was invalided out and received the Distinguished Order of the Brush. Special mention is due to Captain Watts of the Typography Militia, who kept the Boy Scout engineers under iron discipline throughout. More news from the front as soon as it becomes available to the RAD Broadcasting Network. Ted Hewitt reporting.